As a practicing anesthesiologist at Walter Reed Hospital, a frequently deployed member of the U.S. Public Health Service Commission Corps who's helped stand up multiple COVID-19 testing sites, and an individual with asthma and high blood pressure, I am acutely aware of my own increased risk for COVID-19 exposure and the comorbidities that increase my risk of complications. And as the U.S. Surgeon General and a black man, I am equally aware of the symbolic significance of my vaccination today. As I've discussed with faith leaders as recently as last night, the creation of these vaccines is a gift from above. But vaccines, even ones that are 95% effective, will not alone end this pandemic. We must now do the necessary work to go from vaccines to vaccinations. It would truly be the greatest tragedy of all if disparities in COVID outcomes actually worsened because the people who could most benefit from this vaccine can't get it or won't take it. Working to combat mistrust and misinformation will be critical if we are to ensure the equitable protection of all Americans against COVID-19. Lack of trust, especially in communities of color, is not without good reason. The shameful Tuskegee experiments occurred within many of our lifetimes. To truly promote confidence in these vaccines, we must start by acknowledging this history of mistreatment and exploitation of minorities by the medical community and the government. But then we need to explain and demonstrate all that has been done to correct and address these wrongs. The many protections and safeguards in place, like the Office of Human Research Protections, independent institutional review boards, data and safety monitoring boards, the FDA VRBPAC, and the CDC Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices. These are all there to make sure tragedies like the Tuskegee syphilis experiments or the exploitation of Henrietta Lacks never, ever happen again. And finally, we've got to engage trusted voices, medical organizations like the National Medical Association and the National Hispanic Medical Association, faith leaders, and minority gatekeepers like the Historically Black Colleges and Universities, the Divine Nine, tribal leaders, and the National Conference of Hispanic State Legislators, all of whom I've spoken with frequently and as recently as this week. Because when these gatekeepers are informed and confident, their communities will be informed and confident. I want to close by saying I know the importance of representation. Many of you have heard me tell this story. I never believed I could be a doctor, much less the Surgeon General of the United States, because I'd never met another black doctor, even though I had straight A's. The first doctor I met of color was Dr. Ben Carson when I was in college. It took me that long to believe that I could be it, because it took me that long to see it. And that's why I could not be more pleased or feel more called to receive this vaccine that so many people of color had a hand in developing and testing, and that has the potential to correct at least some of the health disparities this pandemic has unveiled. And finally, to all the people of this great nation, it is not only okay to have questions about a treatment that you're being offered, it's normal, and I want you to understand that. But what is not normal is to let misinformation or mistrust cause you to make a decision that is bad for your health. So I promise I will keep working. I'll keep working day and night to make sure you get your questions answered and to restore your trust. I got the facts, and I made a choice to protect my health. When it's your turn, I need you to be informed, and I need you to make a choice that's going to be appropriate for your health.